This part of the world is rapidly changing. The Arctic, which sits in the northernmost portion of the Earth, is sensitive to human activities. The Arctic was once white for most of the year, and now it is increasingly turning blue. This transition is not a surprise because the Arctic is warming up about 3 to 4 times faster than the rest of the planet. There's a lot more playing out in the Arctic, and all these changes might not bode well for the rest of the world. This is the smallest ocean in the world and perhaps the most beautiful. Most of the Arctic Ocean is covered in ice all year round, giving it a brilliant white appearance. The cover, however, isn't permanent. It ebbs and flows throughout the year. It grows dramatically throughout the winter, hitting its peak in March. It is called winter maximum. In the following months, the ice melts, reaching its minimum in September. The ice cover has been on a declining spree in the recent past. Since 1978, satellites have been spying on the Arctic, capturing the extent of ice cover. According to NASA, the September Arctic sea ice is shrinking at a rate of 13% per decade compared to the 1981 to 2010 average. 2012 was the lowest on record. The sea ice extent shrank to 3.41 million square kilometers, which is roughly half of the cover observed between 1979 and 2000. The yellow line represents the average minimum ice extent over the last 30 years. In March 2021, the ice cover reached its maximum of 14.77 million square kilometers, which is 8,80,000 square kilometers below the 1981 to 2010 average maximum. It is the seventh lowest on record. So, why is this a problem? The white ice covering the ocean reflects about 80% of sunlight into space. But high global temperatures, courtesy of climate change, are causing the ice to melt, leaving large portions of the sea exposed to the sun. The sea is dark, and so it absorbs 90% of the sunlight. This has resulted in a rise in temperatures, which further hastens melting. Do you see how this has set off a feedback loop? What's concerning is that researchers predict that the Arctic might see an ice-free summer by 2035. Then there is trouble underneath the surface. About 25% of the entire northern hemisphere is permafrost or permanently frozen ground. The frozen ground contains rocks, soil, and sand bound together by ice. Locked beneath the permafrost are well-preserved remains of dead plants and animals. Rising temperatures are accelerating permafrost melting. When permafrost melts, the dead become exposed. Microbes feed on the dead and release greenhouse gases like methane and carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. Methane, as you know, has 28 times the heating potential of carbon dioxide. Gases trap heat in the atmosphere, and this accelerates permafrost melting. A feedback loop again. If the Arctic warms by 2 degrees Celsius, we might stand to lose 40% of the world's permafrost by 2100, a study predicts. One cannot talk about the Arctic without mentioning jet streams. Jet streams are air currents that flow from west to east at 30,000 feet above the surface. Typically, they act as boundary between the polar region and the mid-latitude. But as the Arctic warms, the temperature difference between the northern polar region and the tropics has decreased. The result? Well, a weaker jet stream that meanders a lot more across the north-south direction, scientists think. This allows the Arctic cold air to plunge south, triggering a cold spell. And the warm tropical air hits north, further warming up the Arctic. The story doesn't end here. Rapid warming is turning the largely white Arctic landmass green. It is changing Greenland. It could be driving extreme weather conditions in the Arctic. Some scientists believe that this might impact the rest of the world in the near future. We cover all of this in our next episode. Do stick around.